السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته dan salam sejahtera yang berhormat Datuk Lee Boon Chye selaku Timbalan Menteri, yang berbahagia Datuk Seri Chen Chow Min selaku Ketua Setiausaha, yang berbahagia Datuk Dr. Nur Hisham selaku Ketua Pengarah Kesihatan Timbalan-Timbalan. Kita ada sini Datuk Dr. Chong, Datuk Dr. Rohaizat dan Datuk Dr. Hisham Shah, ya. Dan tidak ketinggalan Dr. Hayati selaku pengarah kanan Division of Disease Control, ya. Saya teruskan, ya, dengan menyebutkan video conference bersama Menteri Kesihatan Singapura sebentar tadi. Maaf agak lewat kami sebab mengadakan video conference dengan rakan saya di Singapura, Menteri Kesihatan, ya. Kementerian Kesihatan Malaysia ingin memaklumkan satu sesi video conference dua hala melibatkan Menteri Kesihatan Malaysia dan Singapura telah diadakan pada petang tadi kurang lebih pukul 4:30, ya. Ini disertai oleh pegawai-pegawai tertinggi kementerian kedua-dua pihak, ya. Perbincangan berkisar sekitar situasi semasa kejadian 2019 nCoV di Malaysia dan Singapura serta langkah-langkah yang sewajarnya dilaksanakan bagi menangani kejadian jangkitan berkenaan, khususnya melalui pengukuhan kerjasama sedia ada, bilateral kind of cooperation, ya. Melalui sesi perbincangan tersebut, beberapa perkara sebagaimana berikut telah dipersetujui oleh kedua-dua belah pihak. Pertama, menubuhkan satu jawatankuasa kerjasama yang diterajui oleh Timbalan Menteri Kesihatan Malaysia dan Timbalan Menteri Kesihatan Singapura. Ya. Kedua, objektif penubuhannya adalah bagi memperkukuhkan pelbagai usaha merentasi sempadan kedua-dua negara dan disetujui secara bersama. Ya. Dan ketiga, para pegawai kanan dari Malaysia dan Singapura akan bekerjasama dan meneruskan perbincangan dalam masa terdekat bagi mengenal pasti terma-terma rujukan bagi jawatankuasa kerja bersama. Ya. Dan fokus kerjasama dua hal ini adalah seperti berikut. Pertama, perkongsian maklumat dalam bidang kesihatan awam, perubatan dan penyelidikan bagi memastikan penularan jangkitan 2019 nCoV ditangani secara berkesan. Kedua, saringan dan pengurusan kes rentas sempadan Malaysia-Singapura. Dan ketiga, penyeragaman indikasi bagi penggunaan ubat antiviral kepada pesakit yang disahkan positif 2019 nCoV, ya. Mengenal pasti pegawai yang bertanggungjawab contact person di kedua-dua kementerian bagi tujuan komunikasi berkenaan pengurusan kes 2019 nCoV dan pengesanan kontak rapat, close kontak, ya. Itu yang perlu saya sebutkan sebagai apa yang dapat kita rumuskan dan secara muafakat bersama tadi dan dalam video conference kami. Dan selainnya adalah status terkini jangkitan 2019 nCoV di Malaysia ini yang tidak ada makluman kemas kini atau tiada kes baru ingin saya laporkan, menjadikan jumlah kumulatif kes 2019 nCoV yang dilaporkan sehingga hari ini kekal sebanyak 18 kes. Ya. Kalau boleh saya sebutkan, 8 kes dalam kalangan kes PUI, ya, patient under investigation. 8 kes dalam kalangan konteks rapat dan 2 kes dalam kalangan rakyat Malaysia yang dibawa pulang dengan misi bantuan kemanusiaan. Sebenarnya semua itu adalah kekal sama seperti laporan semalam, ya. Dan saya tidak perlu ulang sebenarnya. It's all the same. Semuanya sama, status quo, ya. kekal di laporan semalam. Yang pentingnya adalah rangkuman berita yang kami laporan yang saya bentangkan dalam video conference bersama Menteri Kesihatan Singapura sebentar tadi. Ya, yeah. Itu saja.
There is a need for, again?
For travel advisory. For Malaysians to travel to Singapore.
Kalau boleh saya jawab bahasa Melayu dulu. Inilah perkara yang akan menjadi terma-terma perbincangan dalam jawatankuasa bersama yang dipimpin oleh Timbalan Menteri kedua-dua belah pihak. So these are among the things that we want to discuss in detail over exit screening as to address, you know, the current status, particularly in Singapore where it's gone orange. So those are among the term of reference that we will be dwelling with yeah, on or other. Ya, terima kasih.
Dato' Sri, boleh kata antara benda-benda yang akan dibincangkan oleh sebagai tema rujukan ni adalah sama ada keperluan untuk mengeluarkan travel advisory lah, jikalau perlu lah.
Betul. Particularly over specific cases, we have not. As you very well know, most of our cases came from Singapore. Yeah, all our, in fact, two of our cases, one particular case, datangnya dari the engineer who went to Singapore for conference. That is case 9 atau case 9, yeah. And then the sister who contracted it, and then mother-in-law. So we have three there, and then of course two coming back from the mission bantuan, the evacuation, whatever it is, and then the one that latest from Macau, so six. So we do not get to discuss anything in particular over the case that's originated from Singapore.
Okay. So, yeah. Are there any more Malaysians attended the conference in Singapore?
Not that I know of.
Okay,
not that we know of, yeah.
Ada data terbaru berdasarkan pendidikan membabitkan 1,000 pesakit coronavirus di China. Pada baca tempoh, muka bersih itu, virus tu boleh dikisah pada 24 hari.
Ya.
Jadi ada SOP nak ditukar.
Tidak juga. Saya juga mendapat input daripada pakar-pakar kami untuk menetapkan sebagai 24 hari period inkubasi itu akan membawa implikasi yang pelbagai, dan hampir-hampir mereka mengatakan bahawa ialah satu perkara yang agak sukar untuk kita terima pada ketika ini. Pelbagai penyelidikan sedang dilakukan, akan dikeluarkan, akan dibentangkan, akan di komunikasikan pelbagai findings. Untuk hari ini, bagi kami, kami ambil sikap semuanya adalah tentatif ataupun sementara, sehingga kan kami dapat confirmation daripada pihak kami sendiri, daripada pihak WHO. Ya, kita kena izinkan semua menjalankan kegiatan-kegiatan research, and we should not maksudnya menghukum ataupun mengambil sikap-sikap yang agak terlalu tegas atau keras, tapi we must be open. We will be listening to all, but we have our own opinion at the end of the day, or our stand at the end of the day. Yeah, pada hujungnya kami terpaksa mengambil pendirian kami sendiri.
Ini tu saya datang just to clarify in English. This suggestion to increase the detention period from 18 to 24, since the incubation rate has changed.
14.
Will not be taken for time being since. More research is needed to verify this.
Yeah.
Okay, Channel News Asia.
Yes.
Sarawak has, those returning from Singapore to undergo 14 days quarantine. What is the standard now for Malaysians returning from Singapore? For Singapore coming in here, what is the practice right now?
Still maintain at 14 days incubation, surveillance, whatever. Kita masih, we still maintain it at 14 days.
So even for anyone returning from Singapore, they have to?
Not Singapore. You said earlier, if they have got China kind of travel history.
So for Singapore, there is no requirement.
So far, maybe you know that to be addressed by our working group, but you know as for now, it's still maintained as our own our SOP. No, we don't have that measure.
Both countries are now you're saying that you synchronize how you treat the antivirals and so on. Is there a shortage right now?
Not that we know of. By way of antiviral, our antiviral drug, nope. No, we don't observe that. We do not face that kind of problem. Both sides. Yeah, we do not mention it at all. We do not think that it is a problem. There's not a problem of a shortage of our antiviral drug.
Can you be sharing notes, sharing information?
Yep.
And can you tell us when this will start?
Well, yeah, as soon as we get both our deputy ministers from both sides to convene and to give both in the conference media conference earlier, they will get it start soon as I believe.
May I know why Singapore and Malaysia is doing this? We are not doing this.
We are so close to one another. We have got, you know, historical relationship. We have got good bilateral relationship. All the more we share the same causeway. You know, there are 100 over traveling across each day for reason of family, business and leisure. So all the more why we should strengthen and enhance our cooperation managing this coronavirus outbreak.
All right, Kelvin Jones. May I know whether the Singapore counterpart has reviewed to MOH what is the conference in Singapore rank higher about and which company hosted?
Say it again.
What was the conference about which company hosted?
Yeah. All right. It wasn't a conference as such. It was a company's meeting, a regional meeting. And they were from Malaysia, from China, from Wuhan, from Guangzhou, and other places. So that's about all that we come to know. It is a private meeting of an engineering company, business meeting. It's a business meeting. Okay.
There is no clue review by the Singapore counterpart as in what industry the company is from.
Indeed, we have not asked on that one. Really. Okay.
Last two questions.
I want to know if for those patients yang sudah identified as recovered, will the ministry be keeping tabs on them and for how long?
Right, that's a good question on research. I think I'm sure the clinicians will be very pleased to answer that. Dr. Chores is not around. Maybe Dr. Chong. Dr. Chores is in the round. Dr. Chores, please. It's a question for you, our clinician, yeah? Will we be following on those that have recovered by way of following through post recovery?
For foreigners, of course, they'll be going back. Mm-hmm. For Malaysians, we will be following them up to see what are the antibody responses and immune responses.
Okay, short and sweet.
Last question.
Did the KKM interview the first Malaysian went to Singapore when he back to Malaysia for CFR, right? Then, contacted the virus, spreading the virus via some CNY traditions
like steamboat gathering, because there are Chinese reports saying the steamboat gathering is kind of spreading the virus. If you have forgotten our contact tracing, we have carried it out thoroughly. All our officers, those on the ground, you know, how many did we have? If you could recall, you know, remind me, Dr. Hayati, on this particular case 9. I think the contact tracing involves around 63. If you remember, 63. And who are they, if I may?
Family members.
Friends. All those who have come on board flight as well. We identify those seated nearby, and we went for contact tracing. So it was really thoroughly. As stated by our SOPs, so it was a thorough kind of exercise on contact tracing. So we had about 63 contact tracing.
So the contact tracing didn't show some. They are sharing some
Yeah. But that's like another question, yeah? Okay.
Okay.
All right. Last.
Okay, sorry.
Of four that is related to the first coronavirus case in Singapore. Earlier it was reported that two of them have been tested negative.
Three negative.
Right? After twice. So what is the status now?
Yeah, we had three negatives. You mean which one are you talking about now? Oh, yeah. Three had been negative, yeah?
One more.
And we are waiting for one more. The child. One of the child, yeah. So this is in the pipeline of being. Yeah, they want to be discharged as a family. So they want to wait. Yes, of course. We have Dr. Suresh still to can give you.
They're all very well. We're just waiting for the kids to become negative. So because they want to go together as a family. We didn't
offer
for the grandmother to go back earlier, but they want to go as a family.
They're all asymptomatic now, Dr. Suresh. They are well, very well. So the clinician,
no
Dr. Suresh. Not at all.
No one.
Four people.
No, I'm talking about overall your 18.
Nobody in critical condition, right? No one.
As of now. We hasten to add. Keep praying.
All right, thank you.
Terima kasih semua.